Hello, my name is Abhishek Shukla and I have been working here as a software engineer, and I am going to explain you the Django framework for the Python. Here is the topic which I am going to cover: introduction to Django, Django as a MVC, design pattern, Django architecture, why Django for web development, Django modules, step to create new project, and what Django generates. So here is the introduction part comes. Django is pronounced Django. The D is silent. Django is a high-level Python web framework that encourages the rapid development and the clean, pragmatic design. A rapid development means it's actually application development where programmer don't need to waste time on the for the gathering the requirements. Only the prototype that already exists, just do the, you can say, workshop, also just get the requirement from the customers and start the development. So very less time it can develop the quality level product. So it's you increase the rapid development and the pragmatic design. Pragmatic design means here the name suggests promote the workers and resolve the risk, gathering the all the requirements and concentrate the work on the to the development team. These are the terms come with the pragmatic design. The web framework for perfectionist with the deadline and the primary focus. Django's primary focus is to create the dynamic and database driven website, and second one the content based website. So these are the example. These are the website: Washington Post, eBay, Craigslist, and Google App Engine. They are currently using the Django framework. So these are the examples. And Django is a MVC design pattern. Actually, it is not the MVC. Actually, it is the MVT architecture. MVT architecture is nothing but the model view template. Model that describes the data structure and database schema. So you don't need to create the SQL table. Only you need to just create the table through models.py file. So if you want to means you can create the table and the schema in your models.py, means control what a user sees. Means view is the total handling of the business logic. So whatever the user requests and response are all these things handles with the views.py. And the third one is template. Template means how a user sees it. Means template is just doing the rendering part in your web page. So template, it handle the HTML pages. So whatever you see on a website, so templates just taken care of it. And the last one is controller. So actually it's MVT and MVC, you can say. So controller is URL parsing. URL parsing means URL, actually views is the collection of functions. So URL decides which function is going to call at the same time. So all the control that has been taken care of the urls.py files. So here you can see the architecture. So request browser, user sends the request to the from the browser. So it goes the URL config. So URL config means that selects which function user going to call or which type of request user sends. So URL decides which function we are going to call. So it goes to the views. View is the collection of functions where it has get and post both of the methods. So according to the request, views decide. So views actually, if it's a post call, so it goes to the model. Model is nothing but your database schema. So it means insert the some data or retrieve the data as per the user request. And it also, whatever the request, it also respond to the template. So here is the Django architecture. So response you can see through the HTML page. HTML page is nothing but a template files. So this is the Django architecture. And why Django for web development? Actually, divide the code module into logical group to make the flexible to make. So MVT design pattern, it is a flexible because all the things are means different. Here you can see view is different. Here you can write your business logic URL files that controls over the which function you are going to call. And here is the template file, and here is the model means your database. So it's a flexible, you can change as per your requirement. Second is a provide auto generate web admin to ease the website administration. But actually it also provides the web admin administration, where admin also taken care of the so many things, which user he is going to make super user or staff. So these are the things are provided by the Django. And prepackaged API for the common user task. So it's also has so many packages and module, you can say. So it also provides, so you can use that packages and use in your program. So provide you the template system, define the HTML template for your web page to avoid the code duplication. Actually, code duplication means DRY principle, do not repeat yourself. This is a principle is introduced by the Andy Hunk. Do not repeat yourself means if you want to same thing again, so in Django framework you just use the same thing on a different way. And there are the one more concept is wet. Wet means WET. So that concept was write everything twice or waste everyone's time. So there, this is the difference between dry and wet. So always use the dry concept, because if you are using a wet concept you have to write so much code again and again using the same database. So please use the dry principle. We allow you to define what URLs to be for and given principle, loosely coupled principle. Means define URL coupled principle means it's totally based on the URL. So URL is the controller which controls all the function which is already exists in your views file. Allow you to separate business logic from the HTML. As I earlier told, business logic has been all the code has been written in your views.py, so is it separate from the HTML file? HTML file only for the rendering the content. So it's a totally separate from the business logic. And everything is in Python schema and settings. So all the things are in the Python Django modules. Here are the some modules. Actually, Django provides lots of modules. I am going to explain some modules here. So first of all, administration interface. As I told, the Django is providing the administration interface where admin has the crude interface, where admin has a crude means create, retrieve, update and delete. So these are the permissions the Django admin have. So he, as per his permission, he can add user, delete user, whatever he wants. So Django, this is the one module. Second module is the authentication system. Authentication system means there is a auth user table, which is the one class. So in that class, authentication means every user you can make super user. So all the means username, password, and his email ID, all the things have been saved in auth user table. So it also provides the authentication system. Third one is the comment system. Fourth one is the form handling. Form handling is the very important feature that provides the Django. Form is basically, you don't need to write everything in your HTML file. HTML file, if you want to text box, so you just need input type text, or these are text box, select box, and multiple checks. So in the form handling, Django provides the form.py and the form direct from module, where all the text file integer type or you can define in your form.py file. So whether it also handles your traffic on your web page, because when you are defining your form in your form.py and you said it is a required field, and when you are submit the button, so it does not go to the server side, it checks on the client side. This is why it is very important feature. and again is session. Session is must you have heard means session actually it stores the every website stores the users data and users you can say everything on your server. So when user gets login, so it checks the all this authentication and authorization through the cookie, and cookie does not contain the whole the information about the user, only the session ID, until or unless you are not using the cookie based framework. If you are using cookie based framework, so cookie also has some information about the user, but normally if you are using a simple session, so only cooking through it generates the means retrieve and the getting the response through the session. If session ID is not the same, it directly goes log off. And the other one is the syndication framework and RSS atom feed. RSS is the rich site summary. Rich site summary is nothing but a website that changes rapidly on the same point of time. Means the example is a any news website, you can say means Yahoo News or Times of India, where you can only the refresh the page and currently what is going on in India or in world, you can see the home page. You don't need to go to the particular page or particular thing. So these are the things. RSS is the module where if you want to rapidly change the content, so you can use the RSS module. And the other one is the caching. Caching is the just to prevent the traffic on a particular site. Caching is if you are user requesting the same thing again and again, so the request doesn't go to the server all the time. Sometimes it stores the thing in a caching. Caching means if you are requesting the same page, so it does not go, the request does not go to the server. It's pick the your according to the response, it picks your response from the cache and it shows you. So it is reduces the traffic on your server side. So caching is also very important. And internalization and localization. Internalization, it is the framework which you can develop your application in a multiple language. Multiple language, it doesn't mean you have to write your code in Chinese or something. You write your code in English, but the string whatever you are going to use in your template file, so just means convert all the string into the particular language, or Chinese, Marathi and Bengali, so it will render according to the language selection. So it is so this is the internalization and localization. So here is the demo part. This is the main part, and all the things I have explained, it's basically just the basic thing of the Django. But here is the main part, to step to create the new project. So listen it very carefully, because without it you cannot create or new app or new project. So these are the things you have to follow. First, create the project, start an application, create the database MySQL, define database settings in settings.dot, define your model, add pluggable, write your template, define your views, create mapping, test step, deploy. Okay, these are the steps. So first here I am going to explain. So first of all, you have to install your Django. I am explaining you on, I am using Ubuntu, so I am explaining you in Ubuntu. So first of all, pip install Django. So when you install the Django, then you have to you are going to create a start. Here is a start project is my project. So you have to fire this command, django admin.py start project my project. Here is the my project name, so you can use your project name. So django admin.py start project and project name. Okay, then you can cd my project, means go to the dead directory, project directory. And when you are going to create app, you have to run this command, python manage.py startup my app. My app means your app name. So here you can see the tree. My project contains the one folder my project. One folder my project, there is you can see the settings.py and url.py. url.py is the controller, and here is the your app, my app, which created. And my app, there is views.py. So views.py, that contains the function or your my app. Second is the model.py. Model.py is the schema and your database. So you can create as many as you want in a same project. So here I am only created one project. So this is the tree, and here is the db.sqlite. I am using db.sqlite. So here MySQL, MongoDB, any database you can create. So when you create app, so in a setting.py you have to mention your app name in settings.py file. So there is a installed app. This is the tuple. So in tuple you have to add my app in the last. So as many app you are using, so you have to mention here and add your app. So here my app I have added, and this is the database. And database is I am using SQLite Lite 3. So here MySQL name, engine, username, password. So this is the database. So all these things is in settings.py. Now here is the models.py. Models.py is the database schema. So here class profile is nothing but the table name is a profile. So table contains these are columns. So these columns in name, which is char field, maximum length is 45, roll number, integer field, experience, text field, email field. Here you can also specify the primary key and the foreign key as per your requirement. So when you create the models.py, so these are the two commands: python manage.py, make migration, or here is your app name, my app. So when you run these commands, and second one is python manage.py migrate. So when you run those commands, so it will create the database on your app. So if you are using MySQL or SQLite, so it will create the database and create the table. The third one, actually I have created database and I have some values database. So I am going to explain you how you can retrieve all the values from your database. So here is the code on views.py. Here I am imported the profile. Profile is nothing but a models. So profile is a table name. So here is a def index, and profile is a profile.object.all. So this is a object relational model. So I am fetching all the values from the profile table. And context is, it is a nothing but a dictionary. Here is a key and value pair. So key is my profile, and profiles here all the values. So that contains in this dictionary, and return rendered to respond as index.html and context. I am sending this dictionary to this HTML page, or this HTML page is going to display all the values. So here is the view.py. Now it's the url.py. It controls the function, which function I am going to call. So here I have to mention this is the regex. And here is the means your home page. Home page is I am calling the index function. So when I hit the home page, so it will call the home function. So home function, it goes collect all the information which I have saved in my database and send it to the index.html file with this context dictionary. So in setting.py I have to one more thing I have to mention here, the template. So template is the directory. I have to mention the directory, which directory I am going to use. So I have to mention the directory path name. So this is also important thing. So template, I have mentioned the template, or here is the index.html. In the index.html page, this is a table, and here for loop I have sent the dictionary, and for loop I am fetching the values from that dictionary. So here the profile is a variable and profiles is the dictionary. So I am taking one by one values from the dictionary. So here profile dot name, profile dot experience, because these are the column names. So I am fetching it profile dot name, experience, email, or here is a for loop. So these are the syntax you have to remember when you are using Django. So here is not the simple for loop. One is you have to close the for loop by this. These are the syntax you have to remember. So after that you have to run Python manage.py run server. This is the default server name. If you want to change it, so you can change it Python manage.py run server. Or here is your port number and the IP address. So this is the default name. So if I run the command Python manage.py run server, so here this is the home page, and this was the default my IP address and port number. So here I type IP address and port number. This is the index page, and these are the values which already saved in my database. So here you can see all the values which I have stored. So you can see all the values on the index page. So that's all about the Django, and I hope you are doing well. Good luck for your future.